Pinky's got a story she wants to share with you. Pinky Dinky Doo, never at a loss for what she pulls out of the blue. Pinky Dinky Doo, her little brother Tyler and Mr. Guinea Pig. Pinky Dinky's always thinking big. Yes-a-rooney, positoonie, zip-zam-zoom. Pinky Dinky Doo, in the great big city with all the dinky doos, Pinky makes up stories with fancy words too. She's always acting silly and you'll often hear her say,
now that's something you don't see every day.
Little brother Tyler and Mr. Guinea Pig, Pinky Dinky's always thinking big. Yes-a-rooney, positoonie, zip-zam-zoom.
For you.
Pinky Dinky Doo.
Where are my shoes?
Pinky! Pinky Dinky Doo!
What do you want, Tyler?
Have you seen my shoes? All I can find is a boot and a flipper.
Well, what's wrong with that?
I've got kids' club today. If I don't find my shoes, I'll be in big trouble.
Missing shoes. That gives me an idea.
Pinky, are you going to make up a story?
Yes-a-rooney, positoonie.
Yes-a-rooney, positoonie. We're going to the story box, where Pinky's really good at making up stories. And every story rocks. Story box.
Okay, so one day, in Great Big City, I woke up and Mr. Guinea Pig gave me a big, sloppy good morning kiss. So, what do you think I should wear to school today? Let's see. Should I wear a big, stinky wedge of cheese? Too cheesy. So what about a pretty pet pink pony? Well, I really like ponies, but not pink. I know, my hair is pink, my name is Pinky, but I don't like pink. So, how about my very favourite dress? Perfect!
Pinky, breakfast! Morning, Pinky. Oh, Pinky, do you know gobbling your food makes you burp?
Oh, you're right, Dad. Excuse me.
Told you. Oh, excuse me.
Pinky, hurry up and get your shoes or you'll be late for school.
Meow.
Tyler!
Bye, Daddy Dinky Doo. I love you.
I love you too, Pinky Dinky Doo.
Then I zip-zam-zoomed upstairs to put on my shoes. But there was a problem. I couldn't find my shoes. Oh, no! So I looked under my bed. No shoes. I did some deep clothes diving. Not there. I even looked in the toilet, just in case Tyler had put them there. But no shoes anywhere. Oh boy, I was really, really... What is that word?
I know, Pinky Dinky Doo. You were... exasperated. That means upset and angry.
That's right.
What happens next?
Let's see. I was so exasperated. Oh no! That's a school bus! But I can't go to school in bare feet. What am I going to do?
Pinky! Pinky Dinky Doo! Don't forget your lunch!
I zip zam zoom to the kitchen. I grab my salami sandwich. And then I had an idea. I opened the sandwich, took out the salami, and tied it around my feet with green beans. Mmm, flappy. At school, I went to find my best friend, Nicholas Biscuit. Nicholas! 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 Look at these! I couldn't find my shoes, so look what I had to wear.
Salami! Wow! Look!
Meatloaf?
Yes, they're meatloafers.
Wow! Now that's something you don't see every day. Come on!
Class, the strangest thing happened today. I couldn't find my shoes anywhere, so I had to wear these two roast chickens on my feet. Luckily, I had a third chicken I could use as a matching bag.
Not only that, but Bobby Boom was wearing donuts. And Daphne Toilette was wearing melons.
Are those spaghetti shoes?
No one could find their shoes, so everyone was wearing food on their feet.
Attention, this is Headmaster Fullstop speaking. Due to a tiny mix-up, today's lunch will be trainers with tomatoes, barbecued boots, and for pudding, frozen flip-flops. Mm-mm, that is all.
Yuck! Why have we got shoes for lunch?
Yeah, and food on our feet.
Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy!
All my friends are so upset and angry. They're exasperated.
We're exasperated.
Told you. This is terrible. We really can't eat boots, trainers and flip-flops for lunch. What will we do? It looks like it's time for me to think big.
Stand back, everybody. Pinky Dinky Doo is going to think big.
Wow, good run, hurry.
If I have a problem, don't know which way to go, I think and think and think and think. And suddenly I know.
Come on, Pink, think.
And then it happened. I had a big idea.
Here she comes.
So my dress, I'm telling.
I knew just what to do. We'll swap them. We'll eat our shoes and wear the food.
We'll what?
We'll swap them. We'll eat our shoes that are made out of food and wear the food that's made out of shoes.
Yeah! Yeah!
I led the way as we all trooped down to lunch. Don't worry, Tyler. As this is a made-up story, you don't have to worry about dirty food or germs or stinky feet.
Phew!
Everybody sorted through the food to find matching pairs of shoes. And everybody went home wearing cool shoes and full of yummy food. And that's exactly what happened. More or less, the end. Ow! Tyler, I found your shoes.
Thank you, Pinky Dinky Doo. Now I've got shoes for Kids Club. It sounds like game time.
Say cheese, please.
Cheese, please.
Let's play What Came First? What came first? I'm going to show you some things that happened in my story.
And we're going to say what came first.
That's right, Tyler. I hope you're ready to play. OK, what happened first? Was it I had my big idea? Or was it I couldn't find my shoes? So, what came first? Big idea? Or couldn't
find my shoes.
You couldn't find your shoes and then you had your big idea.
You're right. Okay, so what came next in my story? Was it we ate our shoes and wore the food? Or was it I had my big idea? So, what came next in my story? We ate our shoes and wore the food? Or big idea?
Big idea!
That's right! First I couldn't find my shoes, then I had my big idea, and then we ate our shoes and wore the food. And that's exactly how it happened. All right, let's play one more game. Eat it or wear it. Eat it or wear it, yeah, yeah, yeah. When you see something you're supposed to eat, shout, eat it! Let's practice. A sandwich? Eat it! When you see something you're supposed to wear, shout, wear it! A spacesuit? Wear it! Okay, let's play. Banana split? Eat it! Sombrero? Wear it! Bunny suit? Wear it! Pizza? Eat it! Nappies? Wear it! Well done! I love making up stories! I bet you can make up a story too!